smile, though your heart is aching. Smile even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by if you smile through your fear and sorrow. Smile and maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through for you. Light up your face with gladness. Hide every trace of sadness. Although a tear may be ever so near, that's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just smile.
Please rise for the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, Star-Spangled Banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Good evening. I'm Rory Hume, Dean of the School of Dentistry and Associate Vice President for Academic Affairs for University of Utah Health. As Dean, I'm privileged to have the opportunity to introduce the class of 2024 to their family, friends, and to my academic colleagues. We welcome the new class of 2024. All of you have prepared and are ready for the challenges and fulfillment of your professional journey into dentistry. The class of 2024 represents one of the most excellent and well-prepared groups of dental students that we've welcomed to our school and in all of dental education nationwide. 32 of you are the first in your family to enter the dental profession. Your students from 26 different colleges and universities spanning 19 different states, from Alaska, Texas, Georgia, Massachusetts, Wisconsin, Minnesota, North Dakota, Virginia, Kansas, and many of our immediately surrounding Western regional states. 10 of you speak fluent Spanish. Others speak Arabic, German, Vietnamese, Mandarin Chinese, Korean, Japanese, and Portuguese. 36% of this class is fluent in a foreign language. In addition to completing prerequisite courses, over 85% of you also participated in meaningful research projects, a few of which include collecting DNA, harvesting salamander jaws, isolating bacteriophages, analyzing the effects of spaceflight radiation, assessing cormorant predation on fisheries in Utah, dissecting rat brains and collecting and studying chick embryos. Many of you were employed as tutors, dental assistants, dental hygienists, small business owners, landscapers, salespersons, construction workers, farmers, a whitewater rafting guide, a sushi chef, and a Suzuki certified violin teacher. The list goes on with many wonderful and diverse occupations and rich life experiences. Scholarships and awards were abundant and acknowledged in your academic preparedness and excellence. Your average group GPA is 3.73. Your average DAT scores, 21, 22, 21, are among the highest in the nation. It's interesting to note that a vast percentage of you are highly skilled musicians. In fact, by our count, we could have a very nice orchestra with a large violin and piano section, complemented with percussion and woodwinds. Lastly, I'm personally very interested to note that one of you did a semester studying abroad at the University of Wollongong in Australia. As a class, your broad diversity will greatly enhance the richness of your dental education and the value will carry to your communities when you leave the University of Utah School of Dentistry. Now, please join me in welcoming Dr. Michael Good. Dr. Good is the Senior Vice President of University of Utah Health Sciences, the Dean of the University of Utah School of Medicine, and the Chief Executive Officer of University of Utah Health. He's a professor of anesthesiology. Prior to arriving in Utah, Dr. Good held many leadership positions at the University of Florida and its clinical affiliates, including Chief of Staff and System Medical Director, Senior Associate Dean for Clinical Affairs, Interim Dean, and then Dean. He graduated with distinction from the University of Michigan with a bachelor's degree in Computer and Communication Sciences. Dr. Good also earned his medical degree from Michigan, and he completed his residency training and a research fellowship in anesthesiology at the University of Florida. He joined the University of Florida College of Medicine in 1988. Dr. Good and his wife, Danette, have five children and three grandchildren. Dr. Good.
Thank you, Dean Hume, and hello and welcome to the University of Utah. I'm Mike Good, Senior Vice President for Health Sciences, and it's a privilege to participate in this virtual white coat ceremony. As members of the eighth incoming class of the University of Utah School of Dentistry, you are now part of an integrated health system that will enrich and expand your educational experience. On behalf of all of us at University of Utah Health, I welcome you to our family. This concept of family is very important as you begin your unique journey in bringing oral health and well-being to those you serve. You are a group of 50 students, and you are part of a tight-knit family within the School of Dentistry. You are going to be seeing a lot of each other over the next 4 years. And in this learning community, you will learn how to function as part of a team with each other and with other healthcare professionals, all training together in the allied health disciplines. At the University of Utah, we believe that better solutions come from diverse teams, and stronger education occurs among peers from diverse backgrounds. We look forward to the unique contributions each of you will make during your educational journey. You'll be learning and working together in a state-of-the-art training facility made possible through the generosity of the Ray and Ty Norda Foundation. Ray and Ty Norda had a vision that inspired them to give $30 million to build a school that would train the next generation of oral health professionals. The only stipulation the Nordas made was that we care for the underserved. As our School of Dentistry seeks to improve the overall health of communities in Utah and the Mountain West, bringing care to those who need it most, this has become a defining characteristic of who we are. Thanks to grants and continuing support of our state legislators, you will have the opportunity to improve the lives of countless individuals who would not otherwise have access to your care. This includes caring for elementary school-aged children in the Salt Lake Valley, refugees, those suffering from substance abuse disorder, and blind and disabled adults receiving their care through Medicaid. Starting in the 19th century, and to emphasize the transition to the more scientific approach to modern healthcare, providers and practitioners adopted science's most recognizable symbol, the white coat. As you slide your arms into your white coat, you will be shouldering a new set of responsibilities. You will be clothed in the uniform, a uniform that represents trust, skill, and compassion. Compassionate care based on sound scientific judgment. This rite of passage is a critical transition for you as a dental student preparing to move into clinical environments, and in doing so, to embrace the art and the science of oral health for the betterment of humanity. Congratulations on reaching this important moment. We are honored to share it with you. You have my best wishes for continued success. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Good. It's now my genuine pleasure to introduce our keynote speaker, Dr. Jose E. Rodriguez, the Associate Vice President for Health, Equity, Diversity, and Inclusion at the University of Utah Health. Dr. Rodriguez is a professor in the Department of Family and Preventive Medicine and has extensive background in diversity work in the healthcare area. In addition to his health equity, diversity, and inclusion position, he's a family physician and associate director at University of Utah Health's Redwood Health Center. Dr. Rodriguez is committed to leading University of Utah Health in creating a workforce prepared to meet the needs of our increasingly diverse patient population, providing health care that is equitable and that reduces health disparities. He works to harness the talents of University of Utah Health community to become a nationwide leader in health equity, diversity, and inclusion. Prior to joining the faculty at the U, Dr. Rodriguez chaired the Council on Diversity and Inclusion and co-directed the Center for Underrepresented Minorities in Academic Medicine at Florida State University College of Medicine. He's an accomplished academic, publishing numerous articles on the importance of underrepresented minorities in academic medicine. Dr. Rodriguez received his MD degree at Weill Cornell Medical College in New York and his BA at Brigham Young University. Please join me in welcoming our keynote speaker, Dr. Rodriguez.
Thank you, Dr. Hume, for that warm and generous introduction. I'm pleased and honored to give this keynote address for the White Coat Ceremony at the School of Dentistry. I hope to make my comments both meaningful and brief. The White Coat Ceremony is a relatively new phenomenon, first started in 1993, before most of you were born, at the Columbia College of Physicians and Surgeons. It was designed to mark the transition from pre-professional to professional healthcare studies. Almost every healthcare profession, including veterinary medicine, now has white coat ceremonies, and they are performed worldwide. So today, you join the Worldwide Guild of Dentistry. This is the most challenging time to start a career. COVID-19 has changed how we do business and how we will work in the future. It has illustrated that diseases do actually discriminate, and those of us from communities of color are bearing the brunt of the infections in the United States. Systemic anti-black racism is simultaneously murdering black members of our community, and all of us are angry, incensed, frustrated, and embarrassed that we have tolerated the violence for so long. I could spend the rest of my time talking about what's wrong with the science, with society, but you get the point. We have seen better times. Although we're in challenging times, you are starting a new adventure. It's very exciting. In many ways, it's like leaving your home for the first time to go to kindergarten. You don't know what to expect, but you know that some of the people around you have been through it before. But unlike the first day of kindergarten, you don't have many adults in your families that have completed dental school. And in that way, it's more like leaving the comfort of your living room and going to live in a foreign country that you have never visited before today. Ideally, our dental school is everything you imagined. Shiny new facilities, young, vibrant, smart, engaging faculty and students, as well as state-of-the-art technology. You hope it's also filled with people who are like you and who want to be outstanding dental health professionals. And for the most part, your colleagues are excited and as friendly as you are, and probably just a little bit scared. They, like you, have heard that dental school is hard, and I'm not gonna lie. It's gonna be among the hardest things that you will do in your lifetime. During this time with us, your mind will be challenged in ways that has never been challenged before. You will need to learn enormous volumes of knowledge in less time than you thought possible. The good news is that learning is exciting and it's invigorating, and you get the privilege to continuously learn for the rest of your career. It is perhaps one of the greatest joys of working as a health professional. Another great joy is that the people that surround you today in the virtual room are in the same place as you are. They are beginners and they need to get through the same program that you do. While your competitive spirit may have gotten you into dental school, it is your collaborative spirit that will get you through it. Each one of you has been carefully chosen for your strengths. Use those strengths to build up those who surround you. Building up those around you will help you form lasting, meaningful relationships. The relationships formed in the adversity of dental school will last a lifetime. You will trust people as you never have before, and they will trust you. And even if many years pass without contact, those relationships will remain strong because of the place where they were formed. There are many of you who are new to Utah, and there are many of you who have lived here for years. To those who have been here for more than a month, I say, show your classmates the best that Utah has to offer. And those of you who are just joining us, I say, you came here to learn, and we hope that you stay here to work. Your presence makes Utah an even better place to be. Today's ceremony will allow you entrance into the degree-earning portion of your career. And then the real work begins. Here are some tips that I wish I knew when I started this journey. First, trust your colleagues. They are as smart as you are, and they will become your lifelong friends. Second, treat your schooling as your job. Study as much as you can, but take some time to take care of yourself and spend quality time with those you love. Third, create a new identity for yourself. Starting dental school is a good time for you to adopt your better self. For some of us, it means examining and eliminating our racial and gender biases. For others, it means becoming more of a collaborator. For all of us, however, it means adopting the identity of a University of Utah dental student. A University of Utah dental student is kind, compassionate, friendly, nice, skilled, just, merciful, anti-racist, anti-sexist, inclusive, and outstanding. For sure, these qualities existed in you before you came here. Please make sure to share those with others. Fourth, be grateful. You were chosen to come here because of your accomplishments. As gratitude sets in, It will make the difficult times ahead a little less painful. Fifth, diversify your inner circle. This is a great time to find people who aren't exactly like you to study with. It will help you with your blind spots, and you will help them with theirs. Sixth, take time out to serve. Our dental school was founded with a mission to serve the underserved in dental care. Learn who they are. Love them. Commit to serve them during and after dental school. Remember that providing needed service does more for you as the provider than it does for the patient. Seventh, go outside. You are surrounded by some of the most beautiful terrain in the whole world. Appreciate it, experience it, and then get back to studying. We are creating a new generation of dental professionals and preparing you to lead the nation in care for the underserved. We know that you came here to be educated, and we are delighted that you chose us. We hope that this experience will be transformative for you. Whenever you put on your white coat in the future, please remember this. You have the opportunity to become your better self in the most difficult time of your life. The dental profession needs you. University of Utah Health needs you. Your patients need you, and your colleagues need you. Together, we can lift each other in these difficult times. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Rodriguez, for your inspirational message. Members of our student community will now address the audience. Rogine Cameron-Fard and Jared Teeples, representing the class of 2023, will speak first, followed by Morgan Caneth and Dustin Ellsworth from the class of 2022, and finally, Kelly Glanson and Philip Lusheen will bring a message from the class of 2021.
Class of 2024, my name is Rogine Cameron, and it's my honor to represent the class of 2023 this year at the White Coat Ceremony. Getting to where you are now is not easy. It requires hard work, sacrifices, and patience. So congratulations on making it this far. Finding yourself in a new environment like a dental school presents its own unique challenges and obstacles that you will learn to overcome. One of these challenges is finding friends in your support group. Especially now with online classes, this is getting harder. So please allow me to share my personal experience. When I started my first year, everyone in our class immediately clicked by an applause at the end of our very first class. And ever since then, we are known as the class that claps after everything without ever missing. We celebrate our classmates' birthdays by bringing in treats for everyone and finding out fun facts about them. This is just one example of how we make our classmates feel special and appreciated here. Even after the pandemic, I am extremely proud of my colleagues and faculty for creating an environment of support. From forming study groups to ski trips to the point of transitioning to online classes, we came together, supported, and relied heavily on each other. And these were the moments that defined us as a community. The change to online classes was a learning curve, but we as a dental school community figured it out together and learned a great deal. We learned about the importance and value of communication and feedback to build up our online schedule. We learned how to stay socially connected while physically distancing ourselves. And we even learned how to throw a virtual baby shower for one of our colleagues. And at the end, it all worked out, because our dental school community is strong, inclusive, and supportive. Class of 2024, we are happy you're here and excited to get to know you. We are here for you as you should be there for each other within your class. And I know when I say this, I say it on behalf of every single member of our dental school family. Once again, I would like to congratulate all of you on behalf of the class of 2023 and welcome you to our dental school community.
Hello and good evening. My name is Jared, and I'm honored to be representing my class today, the class of 2023. On behalf of our class, I'd like to welcome you to our dental school community, and I hope that you will feel welcomed and happy here. You will soon come to find that the University of Utah School of Dentistry is a great place to be, if you haven't already. Despite the devastations of the COVID-19 pandemic, the faculty and staff have remained focused on our success and well-being, and they have been very adaptive and flexible in helping our education continue, as they will do for your class. Dental school has been difficult so far, but having supportive faculty members and classmates has made this first year a lot easier than it might have otherwise been. The culture at the dental school is starkly different compared to my experience in undergrad, especially regarding the feeling of competition. There's little to no sense of competition among our class, and I have rarely studied alone for quizzes or exams in this past year. Although I have a regular study group, I feel as though I could turn to any one of my classmates and they would do their best to help me with anything I was struggling with. And I would hope that others would say the same thing about me, that I would be willing to help them with whatever they are in need of. Along with that, I could also say the same thing about all the faculty members here. They are very supportive and helpful. If there is one thing I have learned in this past year, it is that laughter is the best catalyst for learning. So the best advice I could give to you and your class is to find a group or a friend and make learning fun. It'll just make everything stick better that way. While preparing for this speech, I was reminded of a quote that has always stood out to me, which states, "Blowing out someone else's candle doesn't make yours shine any brighter. And may I add, it only makes the environment around you dimmer." We are all part of the community at the School of Dentistry, and when we're working together and building each other up in hopes of others succeeding, then we will collectively burn brighter in a sense, making the school a positive and inclusive place to be. In summary, I believe it is crucial for all of us to individually have a positive attitude and a focus on building each other up in order to maintain a supportive community. The community at the School of Dentistry might not be perfect, but as I mentioned earlier, it is a great place to be nonetheless, and the faculty are among the best doctors and people you will meet. The first year of dental school is very difficult, as you probably imagine, and it's more important than ever for each one of you to support your classmates and continually strive to help each other through these next 4 years. Again, welcome to the University of Utah School of Dentistry, and I look forward to meeting you all eventually. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Morgan Carneff. I'm a D3, and I'm honored to welcome you, the class of 2024, to the University of Utah School of Dentistry. First of all, congratulations on reaching this point in your education and career. I am sure you will hear multiple times today that dentistry is a great profession. And from my experience in dental school so far, I can agree with that. I have enjoyed and learned far more than I ever would have dreamed when I was at my own white coat ceremony 2 years ago. It is not always easy, but neither was getting into dental school. And if you are anything like me, I would have not made it if it were not for the support and encouragement of my family, friends, professors, mentors, and so many more people, my community. I believe dental school is no different. Community is integral to success, both as a student and as a healthcare provider. When I started the first semester, I approached it much like I did my undergrad. I studied alone and tried to plod through the various quizzes and tests, but I quickly found that I needed more than that. I needed a study group, or probably more aptly called a support group. This band of dental sisters has become one of the best parts of dental school for me. The ability to learn, laugh, and lean on them has been a blessing and a privilege. A demonstration of the beauty and power of connection. You are now entering into multiple communities, your new class, the School of Dentistry student body, the University of Utah, and the dental profession as a whole. We are the upcoming generation of dentists. This is our chance, your chance, to foster and create a supportive, warm, and inclusive culture. The small steps we take today, encouraging words, positive attitudes, and a conscientious respect will cultivate and sustain these values. I encourage you to make the effort to invest in the various communities you are part of. because this investment is also an investment into yourself. Take the time to listen to your classmates, ask professors for advice, connect with those around you. It will be well worth it, I can definitely tell you that. We often refer to community as a whole, yet it is the individuals uniting and helping each other that can make or break it. I believe and hope that you will find a vibrant network of support here. Let us work together to continue to improve our communities, one thoughtful action at a time. Thank you, and I wish you the best in your upcoming journey through dental school.
Hello, I want to congratulate all of you for your hard work in getting here, and I want to welcome you to the University of Utah School of Dentistry family. You are now, as of this moment, one of us, and we are better because you are here. As I think about the path that I have taken to become a dentist, I am reminded of a few events that led me to where I am today. I will never forget when an influential business program told me that individuals who help others, especially their colleagues, will never be successful in business or in life. That statement set me on a quest to prove them wrong, and that journey has taken me throughout the world and through several industries. But none of these careers possess the culture I was searching for. Then one day, I was introduced to dentistry by my dentist. I will never forget how my dentist spoke of their competition respectfully and even complimented their work. All the dentists I met while on my journey to dental school never said anything negative about other dentists in their competing market. Honestly, this was baffling to me. My business background had revolved around physicians, corporate executives, and financial gurus that spent a lot of time down-talking colleagues in their respective industry. I realized that dentistry has a professional unity that no other career possesses, and it is up to us to protect it. This collective culture is why the U.S. News and World Report ranks dentistry as one of the nation's top two jobs. It beats out firefighters, astronauts, rock stars, rocket scientists, and even Navy SEALs. I believe dentistry's success is directly related to the unity of its community. When asking dentists advice for tonight's speech, I was told, always give your dental colleagues the benefit of the doubt. And that starts tonight. Your classmates have also worked very hard to get here. And now you begin this next journey together as a team. Yes, dentists and dental students will all have bad days, and sometimes work needs to be corrected. But for that, I always like the statement, praise in public, correct in private. Through unity and by giving each dentist, dental student, or dental specialist mutual trust and respect, we can protect the integrity and autonomy of the dental profession, and thus instill a high level of confidence among our future patients. At my white coat ceremony, we were told about the fantastic culture of dentistry we had just become a part of. One of the speakers told a personal story of when their spouse was diagnosed with a terminal illness. But when things were dark, his colleagues stepped in. Other dentists in his community volunteered their precious time at his office so he could be with his family and not have to worry about keeping his practice running. This is something we can be proud of and something that reflects the values of the dental profession. Over time, you may not remember the specifics of what I am saying tonight, but hopefully I can instill a desire in you to promote the diversity and protect the unity in your class, our school, and our dental community. In the words of Mr. Sinek, when you compete against everyone else, no one wants to help you. But when you compete against yourself, everyone wants to help you. Tonight, I ask you to choose one thing that you will do during the next 4 years to make a positive difference in your classmates' lives. Whatever it is, I will leave it up to you because I know the type of individual it takes to get here. And because of that, I know that through your small acts of kindness, we will accomplish great things together. Thank you.
Hey, class of 2024. My name is Kelly, and I'm about to start my fourth and final year here at the University of Utah Dental School. It's been an absolute honor to have made it this far, and honestly, I couldn't have done it without my classmates. I mean, okay, maybe I could have, but it wouldn't have been nearly as fun. I love my class. I've been saying it since week one, and it still holds true today. We're like a big family, or a small family based off of Utah standards, But honestly, who would have thought that 51 students from all walks of life, all over the United States, would get along pretty well? I mean, sure, we've had our ups and downs. Like I said, we're like a family, but overall, we're just there for each other. So over the past 3 years, we have had a lot of big life moments. We've celebrated each other's births. I honestly stopped keeping track after 25 babies. Even some deaths, weddings, separations, and overall growth. We've pitched in monetarily. We've physically helped each other move. We made meals and even collectively pitched in for a gift when someone needs it. I've been our class's social lead, and there is one thing for sure. Our class likes to eat and to hang out with each other, even on the weekends. I know it seems crazy because you're in the classroom with each other all the time, but honestly, you're the only ones who know exactly what you're going through, and it's fun to be there and kind of commiserate together. So one of my favorite things is during finals week, we all pitched in together and we would do potluck breakfast and lunch. We've even had more than one taco bar during a lecture. And those are great. Those are fun. It's a nice way to break up the monotony of being in the classroom all the time. And okay, I'm going to level with you. Nothing can really make a human form and function exam enjoyable. Sorry, Dr. Fleckenstein. But let me say, a Danbury Cross donut can certainly put a smile on your face just beforehand. And if you're not from here and you don't know what I'm talking about, you do not know the donuts of which I speak, I challenge someone in your class to go out and get them for y'all. Okay, I could talk 4 days about my class, but the point I'm really trying to hit home here is that for the next 4 years, your classmates will be there with you for the best of times and the worst of times. Don't be afraid to ask for help, to look for someone who may need a helping hand and isn't going to ask for it, and just generally being there for each other and build each other up. I love that our school doesn't have a super competitive nature, at least it didn't with our class. There wasn't a single quiz, exam, or practical that we didn't make a big shared editable document. People would upload their notes, graphs, charts, and even make flashcards. Okay, so now that you've been accepted to dental school, just let that sink in for a minute. You're in. Okay, now you will forever be part of the dental community and additionally part of the healthcare field. Medicine right now is taking a move towards a more collaborative environment, and I think that's awesome. And right now in dental school, you can really work on honing in those skills. Please don't ever hesitate to ask anyone for help. If you see someone in the hallway, you don't even have to know their name. Just pull them aside, ask a question. Everyone is more than happy to help. Okay, and I know that with COVID right now and this pandemic, everything's been crazy, and your first couple of years are gonna be different than our years were, but it's okay, you'll get through this. I'm very thankful that the University of Utah has continued to cultivate the welcoming and collaborative spirit that I've grown to love. You guys are about to start the most memorable years of your life. Take it all in, the good, the bad, the ugly. Even on the worst of days, remember, you guys are never alone. We're all here for you, and you guys are in this together. Congratulations, class of 2024.
Once there was a farmer tilling his field outside of a city. A man approached the farmer one afternoon and said, "Sir, I'm looking for a new place to live. What are the people like in this city?" The farmer said, "Well, what are the people like in the city that you're from?" The man said, "They were terrible. There was backbiting and gossiping." The farmer said, "The people in this town are very similar." "It figures," said the man with a shake of his head, and he went on his way. Soon thereafter, a second man approached the farmer. "Sir, I'm looking for a new place to live. What are the people like in this city?" "Well," said the farmer, "what are the people like in the city that you're from?" The man said, "They were great. They were kind. They supported one another. There was a strong sense of community." "That's great," said the farmer. "The people in this city are very similar. I think you'll like it here." The moral of the story is simple but profound. The community that you create is the community that you will have. Let me repeat that. The community that you create is the community that you will have. Here are a few examples of things my class has done to create a good community at our dental school. I have classmates that created flashcards and study guides to share with classmates to prepare for exams for the last several years. I have classmates that advocated for positive change with administration that will help our school for many years to come. I have one classmate that coded an app to help make clinic processes smoother. Something I've been able to do is spearhead an initiative between our school and a nonprofit to give free dental care for veterans in need. These were all done voluntarily. None of them were required. I know each of you is entering dental school with a goal of personal excellence. I now encourage you to add community excellence as well. I wish you all the best and good luck.
Rogin, Jared, Morgan, Dustin, Kelly, and Philip, thank you for your thoughtful and heartfelt words. It's now time for the presentation of the white coats. The white coat has been a symbol of the healthcare professions in the United States and throughout the world for many years. The presentation of the white coat to the students of the class of 2024 symbolizes entering the profession of dentistry and the privilege of providing healthcare to patients. Dentistry is a profession that often requires creative problem solving. Since we can't place a coat on each student and maintain physical distancing this evening, we're creatively solving that problem in the same way that we've adapted to much of the students' education. Tonight, we award the white coats to the class of 2024 virtually.
Noor Adulami. Brittany Bay. Andrew Berquist. Kiana Christensen. William Croft. Madison Davis. Dallas Deal. Rachel Dillard. Ann Din. Brooke Dolan. Matthew Dunn. Nicholas Eccles. Sarah Grady. Heather Grimes. Amanda Harris. Jared Haslam. Trevor John Hawes. Cassidy Hine. Steve Lavity. Zachary Huntsman. Ashton Johansson. Gage Kepner. Benjamin Lobby. Kendra Law. Ryan Lim. Emma McAllum. Preston Miller. Elisa Moffett. Helen Moon. Nate Naylor. Tanner Nelson. Kaylee Newcomb. Jared Norseth. Mara Overby. Taylor Peterson. Morgan Pitcher. Molly Reisenauer. Garen Riggers. Xenia Rodriguez. Alexandro Rolas Carmona. Mikel Rumbaugh. Adam Shinahara. Joel Silva. Yasmin Saripatan Castro. Austin Stephenson. Yukiko Steven. Clinton Stewart. Natiri Swenson. Derek Thomas. Courtney Westover.
Congratulations, class of 2024. Dr. Lauder will now administer the student dentist pledge. Dr. Gary Lauder was part of the inaugural faculty of our school and has served the University of Utah School of Dentistry faithfully for many years as director of admissions and as a student advocate. As he transitions to his new role supporting our Pathways curriculum, he'll remain the caring presence and the champion for students that he's always been. Thank you, Dr. Lauder, for your ongoing commitment to the school and for continuing to be an inspiration to our students. Dr. Lauder.
Will the students please stand to recite the Student Dentist Pledge? The pledge will be projected on the screen, and I ask you to read it along with me. I accept this white coat as a pledge to all, that I will dedicate myself to the highest traditions and aspirations of the profession of dentistry. I will honor the sacred trust placed in me by family, peers, patients, co-workers, and institutions that rely on my skills and integrity for care, understanding, and compassion. With all diligence, I will prepare myself through committed study and masteries of the principles and science of health, especially as they pertain to the oral health and overall well-being of my patients. As a perpetual student, I will continue to dedicate myself to use and advance my understanding and to enhance my skills to better serve my patients and community. I will exercise the rights, privileges, and confidence bestowed upon me with commitment, competence, and compassion in order to cultivate and represent the finest traditions of the dental profession.
Dr. Jerry Bullock, on behalf of the Office of Admissions and representing the faculty, administration, and staff, please join me to welcome the class of 2024 to the University of Utah School of Dentistry. Dr. Bullock joined the school 3 years ago with the mission to educate students to treat underserved communities as the dental director of the South Main Clinic. She is now the co-director of admissions, bringing passion for inclusion and diversity within dentistry to that role.
Congratulations, class of 2024. Welcome to the University of Utah School of Dentistry. You are now part of a very special community that not only wears white coats, but is centered around equality, excellence, and an enormous sense of service. The American civil rights activist Cesar Chavez said, "We cannot see achievement for ourselves and forget about progress and prosperity for our community and the needs of others, for their sakes and for our own." When the COVID-19 pandemic hit, it was easy to turn inward and say, "I have to look after myself." But that is not what our community did. Students rallied to provide support for each other and faculty as we moved to online learning. they took on and helped to change old legislation to allow a mannequin-based dental licensing exam, and then helped those across the nation do the same. Our administration saw the importance of safely reopening clinics to ensure that all Utahns, regardless of their social economic status, have the ability to safely seek dental care during the pandemic. And now we welcome you to our community. You are not leaving your old communities to join this new one, but you bring them with you to nourish and strengthen ours. Call on those communities when things get tough, and trust me, they will get tough. Be open to support from others. Accept the notes from someone who is offering them. Let your partner make dinner so you can study one more hour. Truly accept the words of encouragement. You can do this. And at the toughest hour, evoke the spirit of that child back home who says, "I never knew I could be a dentist," and sees you as a superhero. As you heard from the bio of your class, you were the most accomplished and diverse class that has ever entered the University of Utah School of Dentistry. As such, I challenge you to never forget the progress and prosperity of your communities in the pursuit of your achievements. Support each other and serve others in need for their sake and for your own. Welcome.
Thank you, Dr. Bullock. I now have the privilege to welcome Dr. Michael Smuin, representing the Utah Dental Association. On behalf of the profession, Dr. Smuin will welcome the students to the profession of dentistry. Dr. Smuin is a general dentist who's a solo practitioner in Vernal, Utah, way to the east. He attended the College of Eastern Utah, the University of Utah, and is a 1994 graduate of the University of Nebraska Medical Center College of Dentistry in Lincoln, Nebraska. He's a fellow of the Academy of General Dentistry. He's enjoyed his time of service in the Utah Dental Association and currently serves as its president. He and his wife, Holly, are the parents of four children and two grandchildren.
Thank you, Dean Hume, for the invitation to say a few words today. As president of the Utah Dental Association, it is my pleasure to welcome you into this noble profession and encourage you to make a commitment to belong to your profession's association. The American Dental Association was founded in 1859 and serves the profession, the public, and individual practitioners throughout the world. Its mission statement is, "The American Dental Association exists to power the profession of dentistry and to assist our members in advancing the overall oral health of their patients." The ADA is organized into local districts and state associations, and of course, the national organization. So no matter where you are in this country and beyond, the ADA and state associations are there for you. As a student, I encourage you to become a member of the American Student Dental Association, ASDA. With that membership, you become a student member of the American Dental Association. It will cost you a few dollars, but I assure you, the dues spent on membership will provide benefits far beyond the expense. 30 years ago, as a student at the University of Nebraska, I made the choice to be a member of ASDA and have continued my membership in the ADA to the present time. I had no idea that one day I would be highly involved in the Utah Dental Association and the American Dental Association as well. It is a great privilege to serve and work with so many remarkable dental professionals. Many of those professionals are right here at the University of Utah. I have been a solo general dentist for the past 26 years in Vernal, Utah. I think you have made an excellent career choice. I am very optimistic and excited about your future as well as my own. I hope at some future time, we will be able to have a more personal conversation and interaction. And so, I wish each of you the best of luck, and always know that the Utah Dental Association is here to assist and serve you. Thank you and good luck.
Thank you, Dr. Smuin. Now, please join me in welcoming the class of 2024 into our university, our school, and the profession. I'd like to once again thank all of our guests for being here today. At the conclusion of this ceremony, please join us as we celebrate the success of the class of 2024. That celebration will be by Zoom. You will have all received an email with the link to our virtual ceremony. You can share this link with your family and friends. Please rejoin us for a virtual celebration at 6:30 p.m. Mountain Standard Time.